Pandharichi Wari, a traditional pilgrimage from Maharashtra. Thousands of people from different corners of Maharashtra congregate on the banks of the river Chandrabhaga. Every year, in the month of Ashad, it is a journey taken up in search of the lovable and loving deity, the Lord Vitthal. Pilgrimage is an ancient human tradition, and it takes the devotee from the plains to the hills, to the shrines on top of the mountains, and to the origins of the sacred rivers. In many ways, life is a journey, a pilgrimage in search of the meaning of the life itself. Mountaineers are a different kind of pilgrims, and their meaning for life is to climb. These pilgrimages go on for many days, and a day comes to an end. After a hard day's journey, people settle down for the night around a campfire. I have been around many such campfires. You come to know a lot of interesting stories around these campfires. And today, I am going to narrate one such interesting story of a pilgrimage. Giripremi is a well-known mountaineering club from Pune, formed in the year 1982. In the month of May 2007, they planned an ambitious expedition in the Gangotri area. Gomukh, the origin of sacred river Ganga. Around Gomukh, there are many shining peaks, and the most stunning of them is Mount Shivling, a beautiful giant reaching a height of 21,467 feet. Any mountaineer who visits Gangotri region falls in love with this challenging peak and invariably has a burning desire to scale Mount Shivling, a pilgrimage that keeps beckoning him. It was first climbed in year 1981. Many foreign expeditions and Indian Army expeditions have reached the top, whereas many Indian civilian teams have failed. The mountain has claimed some lives too. It was year 1993. Giripremi had planned an expedition to Mount Shivling. The team reached a height of 19,800 feet. Unfortunately, Surendra and Prasad, the lead climbers, were struck by a vicious avalanche. Date: 16th May 1993. They had to turn back. The expedition was planned for the pre-monsoon season of 2007, and the special occasion was Giripremi was completing 25 years. The preparations began almost a year in advance. The team was going to consist a dozen members, and the expedition was planned for 40 days. The total food was going to weigh 800 kilograms and almost the same weight of climbing equipment. The food and equipment planning needs to be done very meticulously. You cannot even miss out a needle. Elaborate lists were prepared. Day-wise planning for the food is mandatory. Technical equipment needs to be packed separately. You need to be a far better housewife. 1.6 tons of food and equipment got packed and ready by 11th of May 2007. Regular meetings were taking place for planning the complicated logistics of this expedition. Along with this, a rigorous schedule for fitness and technical training was underway for all the members. At last, 12th May 2007, blessings and well wishes of relatives and friends were bestowed on the team members. This day, the advance team started from Pune. A coconut is offered as an auspicious beginning. Preparations were over, but the butterflies of uncertainty remained. The advance team was going to travel north by Jhelum Express. Prestigious flags and mementos were given to the team. There were rounds of shake hands and warm hugs. These happened. Very few words were shared. A journey with a lot of hopes, ambitions, and trepidations was just beginning. The rest of the team started on 15th of May 2007. Both the teams travelled by road from Delhi to Rishikesh and then climbed into the foothills of Himalaya to reach Uttarkashi. The total distance is about 400 kilometers. The team traveled further 90 kilometers to reach Gangotri. The team met the high altitude porters and the porter agency in Uttarkashi. Porters play an important role in ferrying loads to different camps up the mountain. Porters and team members stay and work together in all sorts of conditions on the mountain. This almost becomes like a big family. Gangotri, height approximately 10,000 feet. This is the last small village before moving on to Gomukh. It is said that the snout of Gangotri Glacier used to be at Gangotri. Our carelessness and the global warming has probably pushed the snout of the glacier back towards east by 19 kilometers to Gomukh. Photo loads were made and distributed at Gangotri. A low altitude porter carries about 25 to 30 kilograms of load. The expedition had a team of 53 porters from Gangotri to the base camp at Tapovan. Impressive Sudarshan silently witnesses the approach march. Bhujbas and Lal Baba's ashram on the way to Gomukh. Playful Bharals, that is the mountain goats, are seen on the way. The 19 kilometers march towards Gomukh goes through rough terrain. First glimpse of the objective, Mount Shivling. Tapovan is situated on the true left bank of Gangotri Glacier. Stark towering peaks of Bhagirathi group were visible. The team toils up to the base camp at Tapovan, height 14,500 feet. Sorry, I forgot to introduce the team. Rahul Yelenge, Rahulya, age 21, leader and the summiter. Avinash Kandekar, Avya, age 30, deputy leader and summiter. Anand Mali, Andya, age 24, looked after medical supplies, summiter. Tekraj Adhikari, Kancha, age 25, kitchen equipment, summiter. Anand Patre, age 29, equipment in charge, summiter. Mahesh Kalbhor, Maya, age 29, quartermaster, summiter. Rupesh Khopade, age 25, support member, summiter. Nilesh Avare, Chotu, age 23, support member. Yashadeep Malvade, age 28, looked after photography. Ajit Tate, Tate Kaka, age 42, base camp manager. Sanjay Doifode, age 41, logistics. Umesh Jhirpe, Mamia, age 42, organizing secretary for the expedition. The team was supported by high altitude porters, namely Gyalbu Sherpa, Pasang Sherpa, Lakshman Singh Rana, Raju Sahi, Chandra Bahadur and Suresh were the cooks. Base camp is a place to sort out further movements, rest, and this needs to be a nice and cozy place. At the start of the expedition, a puja was offered to Lord Ganesh for an auspicious beginning. technical equipment, both personal and climbing, was sorted out. The team now had to plan further load ferries to advance base camp. The team had a serious meeting to review the logistics. The route details were once again checked out. Regular avalanches from Mount Shivling and also from the neighboring peaks provided a threatening background music. The team started to move towards advanced base camp on 23rd May. Looking down, the base camp started becoming smaller. The expedition had the first taste of bad weather on 26th May. It snowed heavily. The base camp got covered in a white blanket. Morning sun rays were cold. A hot tea was welcome. At this altitude, temperature can go down to minus 10 degrees Celsius. Bad weather means cleaning up operation becomes mandatory. The route to advanced base camp went over a series of lateral moraine ridges of Meru Glacier. Loose earth and negotiating boulders can be tedious. The route to advanced base went around the pyramid of Mount Shivling, approaching the base of the western flank. Looking down, tiny figures at the base camp. The dirty, grumbling expanse of the Gangotri Glacier. The team had already made two ferries to advance base camp by 26th May. Sadly, Mamia had to leave due to urgent commitments in Pune. A warm farewell was given to Mamia. A lazy base camp gets ready for further action. The shining summit of Mount Shivling is now beckoning. Five climbers and five high altitude porters got ready to shift to the advanced base camp. May 27th, 2007. Walkie-talkie crackles to life at the base camp. The first team occupied the advanced base camp on this day. Height 15,500 feet. The winds were freshening up. Advanced base camp overlooks Meru and Gangotri Glacier. As the sun comes up, avalanches start rolling down. The team will need to be careful. May 20th, the team started pushing the route to Camp 1. There were two avalanche-prone areas en route to Camp 1. Walking and crunching on crisp snow in the morning is a great pleasure. The route went through this flattish section. The gradient is deceptive. Mount Meru stands tall in the background. Advanced base camp was going to be at 15,500 feet. Avalanche debris can be seen. Tons of snow and ice comes rolling down, and it can be deadly. Final slope leading to Camp 1. The oxygen starts depleting at this altitude. Acclimatization becomes extremely important. Looking up the threatening icefall at the base of the summit and the ridge leading to it is clearly visible. Beyond the northern ranges, peak Sudarshan peeps out. Height 21,342 feet. At this altitude, everything freezes. Finding a water hole is a luxury. Acclimatization means getting your body used to low oxygen level. The principle used is climbing high and sleeping low. One makes a couple of load ferries to a higher camp from the lower camp and then occupy the higher camp. If this is not done properly, it can very easily result into high altitude sickness. Team members returning after the load ferry. One has to be extremely careful in the avalanche prone area. As the day is getting warmer, a new form of tap dance. It is needed to create a flat platform for pitching the tent. At Camp 1, there were two three-man tents. There was also a shelter created for food and equipment dump. Choosing a proper site and establishing the camp properly becomes extremely important on an expedition. Camp 1 was at a height of 16,800 feet. The team started opening the route towards Camp 2 on 31st May. The route travels these slopes to get on to the ridge. Camp 1 has started looking cozy. During load ferries, meeting members coming from the lower camp becomes an important occasion. 3rd June. That evening, it snowed again. Barring few occasions, Weather God was good to the expedition. The team had excellent clear spells of good weather. At this altitude, even making tea or drinking water is a time-consuming job. It starts with melting ice and the process goes on. The camp 2 was going to be at 18,500 feet. After this, the route followed the sharp ridge approaching a 200 feet ice fall. This was almost like a fort wall, guarding the route to the summit. The last night's snowfall made this initial approach difficult. The real technical and hard climb started from this stage. After opening a particular section of the route, it is secured by a fixed rope. This makes ladder climbing easier. Looking down, we can see tiny dots of Camp 1. Being on the ridge made the team a bit safe from the avalanches pouring down from both the sides. The rumbling sound was not very encouraging. At times, the team had to wade through waist-deep snow and at times tackle hard ice slopes. Summit looks deceptively close. The towering ice fall is awe-inspiring. On 3rd June, the team occupied Camp 2 on the ridge. This particular traverse was a playground for avalanches. You need to cross this section quickly. This is no place to linger and appreciate the beauty. Even with a fixed rope in place, climbing with load was a demanding task. These marker flags dotted our route. It helps in bad weather to find a camp safely. To begin with, you need to shift tents, adequate food and equipment to a campsite. And then only you can establish a higher camp. On difficult sections, you always remain attached to a fixed rope. A wrong step here can take you tumbling down thousands of feet. Starting on the slopes leading to the ridge ahead of Camp 2. A wonderful panorama unfolds. The conical peak of Mount Sri Kailash. Sudarshan and Yogeshwar. Peak Matri. The shark fin of Peak Manda. Bhrugupanth is in the background. Looking down on Meru Glacier, Camp 1 is visible. Cutting a platform in hard ice for tents at Camp 2. It is a back-breaking job at this altitude. Inching your way up these slopes is not a joke. You keep panting for breath all the way. Crampons. These are artificial set of metal teeth attached to your boots, which help you climbing on hard ice. Looking down, you cannot afford to have a weak stomach. By 4th June, Camp 2 was stocked up, and the team had started opening route to Camp 3. The Camp 2 was at a height of 18,500 feet. The Camp 3 was going to be at a height of 19,800 feet. Avalanche debris is evident all around. One would love to move fast, but the altitude keeps dragging your feet, panting lungs, and your heart keeps doing overtime, both with exertion and raw fear. Jumar is a clamp which you can use to climb on fixed rope. Fixed rope is anchored to snow stakes or ice pitons. Camp 2 was perched on a windy ledge on the ridge. Approaching Camp 2 with Manda in the background. On 6 June, second team occupied Camp 2. Rahulya, Andya and Kancha were forcing the route towards Camp 3. While second team was stocking up Camp 2 and supporting the climb ahead. Expedition effort is like a pyramid. Totally, 1600 kilos of food and equipment reached base camp, whereas only 80 kilos of food and equipment reached Camp 3. In this pyramid, the supply chain is of an extreme importance. Staying at this precarious location makes you feel heady. The team found innovative ways of using solar energy at this altitude. A makeshift mechanism for collecting water. A golden morning smiles on the south summit of Mount Shivling. Starting towards Camp 3, finding your way through these boulders is tricky. After about 500 feet of steady climb on this ridge, the team had to tackle an open bookshelf. A bookshelf is a formation of two walls flanking away at right angle. The ridge snakes away in the background. Camp 2 is visible. After clearing the bookshelf, another steady climb for about 250 feet. The team encountered a series of two chimneys. These huge granite boulders seem precariously balanced. Climbing with a loaded rucksack in a chimney is a difficult task. You wriggle, you struggle, and snake away your way up in this chimney. Way down, the sleepy python of Meru Glacier. From Camp 2, the route traverses under this tower. The route to Camp 3 steadily and steeply climbs over this ridge more than 1,000 feet, and then through the chimneys to Camp 3 at a height of 19,800 feet. Magnificent Manda seen in the background. impressive summit of Bhrugupan. Climbers approaching Camp 3. Now the fort wall of Icefall looks very close. At this height, 10 steps and stop panting for breath. It is very tempting to slump down and go to sleep, even though it might be your last one. In the madness of broken rock and ice, Camp 2 is visible. Final loads were carried towards Camp 3 in preparation for the final push. Tackling the chimney was a major roadblock. Sometimes the sacks had to be pulled up. Meru Glacier, at least 4,000 feet below. Pitch by pitch, you kept climbing, and it seemed almost never ending. In the second chimney, the team had some epics. Maya got stuck, while Yashadeep managed to dislocate his shoulder. Evening settling down at Camp 3. The tents were anchored down with ropes. The gusty winds at this altitude can even take a tent away. A climber is seen approaching the fort wall. This was also the location of 1993 accident. You needed a steely nerve to tackle these slopes with the hanging sword of the ice fall. The broken chunks of this ice fall can come crumbling down anytime. By now, the major difficulties were behind. Now the only big hurdle was the fort wall. A close look at this ice wall. Warm sunlight, cool breeze, and a steaming cup. You're almost in the heaven. Getting ready to attack the fort wall. Like in a battle, you wear a lot of protective gear to make this climb safe. The battle at the fort wall. It was amazing to watch Gyalbo and Raulia opening the route on the ice fall. Camp 3 is visible. Shimmering, sparkling, hard blue ice. Crampons biting in precarious toeholds. Ice hammers offering unbelievable pinch holds. It was almost like watching a ballet in the slow motion. Now it was only 1500 feet to the summit. The first summit attempt began at 4 a.m. on 9th of June. The team quickly tackled the fort wall. From here on, it was a sheer slope at 85 degrees, leading to the summit. There was a big crevasse, a bergschrund, about 700 feet below the summit. Lungs were gasping for breath. Feet were struggling to move. The team had to be roped up. Chances of small slip-ups are high. and any slip up at this altitude is unpardonable. 10 steps, stop. Regain your breath, start again. It went on. The summit seemed so close and yet so far. Wind was lashing away at our clothing. The cold had seeped through to the bone marrow. There was a kind of numbness taking over. You had to jog yourself into senses and keep climbing. You kept looking around while resting. Slowly the west summit slipped lower and you knew the summit was close. At last, the team was just 20 feet below the summit. And they had promised themselves that they will not step on the summit, as it is a tradition to respect Mount Shivling. The team had successfully scaled Mount Shivling. Time 13:45 hours. Date 9th June 2007. There was a great jubilation. The walkie-talkie crackled to life. The success news was infectious. Giripremi team had successfully climbed Mount Shivling. A great way to celebrate the Silver Jubilee. The first team consisted of Rahul Yelange, Anand Mali, Tekraj Adhikari, Galbo Sherpa and Pasang Sherpa. Looking down, tiny dots of Camp 3 and Camp 2. The total route from Advanced Base Camp to Camp 1 to Camp 2 to Camp 3 and the base of the fort wall is visible. A warm welcome to the first summit team after the success at Camp 3. The mood was upbeat. A scanty meal of noodles was also a great treat. Second team consisting of Avinash Kandekar, Anand Patre, Mahesh Kalghor, Rupesh Khopade, Lakshman, Chandra Bahadur and Raju Sahi reached summit at 14:43 hours on 10th June. The team left a small idol of Lord Ganesh on summit. A magnificent panorama from the summit. Manda, Bhrugupant, Thale Sagar peeping from behind Meru, Kedarnath peaks. The team started coming down. This is the time in the expedition when one has to be extremely careful. Deep down, Meru Glacier. Now the fort wall was friendly. Dancing down the ice wall, there was a happy bounce in the steps. All the camps got wound up. The base camp is getting ready to start the journey down. Winding up camps and taking care of garbage is an important discipline that the team followed. Now it was the time to take in and soak the beauty of the journey back home. And yes, the home was beckoning strongly now. Our returning steps took to wings. Hey, Deri Chanderi. Now the home was very near. A great celebration awaited the heroes. So friends, here was the story of a successful expedition to Mount Shivling by Giripremi in their silver jubilee year. Standing on the summit, many feelings were flooding in. All the efforts, hardships were forgotten. The pilgrimage was successful. The journey was exciting, enthralling, and deeply satisfying. For these pilgrims, the journey continues. More pilgrimages will follow.